Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. I am Swati Jain and in today's video I'm going to give you the glimpse of all the accommodations that I stayed in during Kailash Mansarovar Yatra. So in case you want to see what the accommodations at Mount Kailash Yatra looks like, stay tuned to this video. But before starting with this video, let me remind you that Mount Kailash is tucked into one of the remotest areas in China. And irrespective of the fact that this pilgrimage site is really expensive, please expect basic facilities at some places and sometimes on sharing basis too. Also for the accommodation part, unfortunately I don't have much footage because I didn't intend to make this video. But since I am getting comments on my previous videos on Kailash Mansarovar Yatra, I thought of making this video. But rest be assured, I am going to keep it as detailed as possible. So let's get started. Nepal is decent with the hotel stays, but the stay category depends on your package that you have opted for Kailash Mansarovar Yatra. But generally speaking, you will get good properties to stay in Nepal. The next stop, which is the last village of Nepal before the China border starts, unfortunately I didn't really get to stay there as we had to take an early haul due to landslides. But what I have seen is that they have basic stays with common washroom. Keerong, the border town of China. Now in China, there are limited hotels and guest houses that caters to the foreign tourists. So in peak season, there are shortages of the room. It depends on your luck if you shall get an individual room or on sharing basis. Overall, a decent stay in Keerong. The next stop, which is Saga, is a commercial town and therefore expect a decent stay here. Mansarovar Lake. Well, we stayed in a basic guest house right in front of the Mansarovar Lake, which had a dome setting and no toilets. The next place where I stayed during the Mount Kailash Yatra was Taklakot, again which is an administrative town and you can expect decent stay here. Next on the route was Darjeeling. Though the stay here is decent enough, but sometimes you may be required to share the room with other people depending on the availability of the room. Deraput, which is the first stop during Kailash Parikrama, had very basic guest house and no toilets. Zuthalpuk, where you are going to stay on the day 2 of Kailash Parikrama, again had a basic guest house and no toilets. So that's about this video guys, but let me remind you again guys, don't go with a very high expectation because Kailash and Mansarovar is actually tucked in into one of the remotest area in China, but the experience that you are going to get at Lord Shiva's abode is something that you are going to cherish for your life.